Hello guys, today I'm going to do the first example on your heat transfer. So I'm doing an example on your heat transfer today. Your first example. I'm not going to write the question down, but I'll read the question for you. This is a question from one of past papers. I'm not sure which one, 2018 or 2019, one of those past papers. Now, I will read. They say a piece of a steel with a mass of 21 kg at a temperature of 89 degrees Celsius. So, as I'm reading, I will just write it at a time. They say you have your steel, the mass of your steel. So, in writing our data, they say the mass of your steel is 21 kg. And then at a temperature of 89 degrees. So, initial temperature of your steel is 89 degrees Celsius. And then is immersed in 5 liters of water. Then the mass of water, so 5 liters is equal to 5 kg. So it's 5 kg. Let us look at the temperature of water. At a temperature of 17 degrees. First temperature, initial temperature of water is 17 degrees Celsius. And then the question is, calculate the final temperature of water if no heat is lost. So they want temperature final. So you had a steel at this temperature of 21 kg at 89 degrees, and then you put this steel at 5 liters of water. So if it's water, 5 liters equal to 5 kg. The temperature of water is still 70 degrees Celsius. Now if you take a whole steel and you put it into water, they will have an equilibrium temperature, meaning the final temperature is the same. They want the final temperature. So this is the data that they gave you. When you go at the back of your question paper, you have what is called information sheet, because this data is incomplete. At your information sheet, you will find the specific capacity of your steel, which is 500 joules per kg per degree Celsius, and then specific capacity of water is 4187 joules per kg per degree Celsius. You must make sure that your mass is in kg, make sure that your specific capacity, both are in joules or both are in kilojoules, but the SIV should be the same. So everything here is fine because it is in joules and this one is in joules. Your mass is in kg, since it's joules per kg. So this kg must cancel the kg. Alright. With this data given, they want your final temperature. What you know at this stage is that your heat, which will be lost by steam, will be equal to your heat, which will be gained by water. So you know for conservation of energy. Now what is your heat of a steel? It is your mass of a steel, specific capacity of a steel, change in temperature. Remember, with your steel, your temperature will drop. So you still have a high temperature in water, that means the temperature of your steel will drop. So you have the mass of a steel, specific capacity of a steel. Since it will drop, that means your initial temperature is greater than your final. So you say initial minus your final temperature, since this one will be smaller than that one in terms of your steel, since it's the one that will lose the temperature. So your mass of a steel is 21 multiplied by specific capacity of a steel is 500. Initial temperature of a steel is 89 minus the final temperature that you are looking for. Now when you add all that, you will have 934,500 minus 10,500 final temperature. This is your equation number one. And then temperature of water heat gained by water is your mass of water, specific heat capacity of water, change in temperature. This one, temperature will rise. Meaning, you have a mass of water, specific capacity of water, final temperature will be bigger than your initial temperature. So I will say final minus initial, since this one, your temperature will rise. So your mass of water is 5, specific capacity of water is 4187, final temperature minus the initial temperature of water, which is 17. So on this one, we already have 20890 final temperature minus 355130. That is equation number 2. Now you equate these two equations. You know that energy of a steel is equal to energy of water. We don't consider any losses. So with your steel, you have 93500 minus 10500 final is equal to your water is 2080 final minus 355130. Now your only unknown is your final temperature that you are looking for. This is negative. I will take it on the other side. So I will have 10500 final plus 2080 final is equal to, I'm taking this one on the other side. So you're making your final temperature is in the formula. So when you're adding these two, we have 31390 final temperature is equal to 1289630. So you divide with 31390, you find your final temperature. It's 41.084 degrees Celsius. So this is how you find the final temperature of the heat transfer. Your heat loss by your steam as well, cut your heat gain by water. So this is an example where you use a specific capacity of your. So you just have two materials. One material will get an energy from the other. So this was just the first example under your heat transfer. So the next example will include your heat gain. Second example. Thank you.